Disclaimer: Red Dead Redemption is an 18 plus game that includes violent actions. This video contains no blood or violence and is a roleplay, and therefore might not be accurate to real life. Please keep that in mind as you watch the video. Enjoy! Hello guys, this is Sandy and welcome back to my channel and to this vlog. Today is a special day because my friend is coming here to America and gonna spend a whole day with me for a whole week. And we are gonna go on a little hunting trip. Now, Mizuu and I both got our hunting license 2 weeks ago, and we thought it could be nice to do our first hunt together. So we have booked a 3-day hunting trip in the mountains above Strawberry to see how lucky we can get. Before I meet her, I just need to get ready. Yeah, looks fine, I guess. Oh, hi everyone. Oh yeah, this is my house, by the way. It seems probably like nothing on the outside, but on the inside, it is kind of charming. So it is not so bad. At least it is close to everything here, especially the train station. Speaking of the train station, I am gonna go and pick Mizuu up from there right now, and we will take it from there. Mizuu comes all the way from Germany, so she has traveled quite a distance to be here. So I'm sure she must be tired with the different time zone and all. I gotta say, it was really nice to see her again after such a long time. We decided though it was best to start the journey the next day as early as possible. The day of the trip. It is early morning here at Valentine and the sun is shining brightly. We decided just to buy something small from the store as breakfast along with other needed items before heading out. We have some treats for the horses that we're gonna ride on this trip. Some extra clothes, walkie-talkies, and of course, our phones. That is pretty much useless because they have zero reception. That is why we have walkie-talkies with us, because they we can trust. This is the route we're gonna be taking for the trip to the camp and back home again. I want to point out that we have our cameras with us. I also have a drone with me that will be recording, and yeah, that's what drones do. Fly above you and stuff. Now we have rented 2 horses from a side called the Emerald Mountains. Now this side had many pretty and nice horses, and both me and Mizuu have experience in riding. They ask some questions on your riding skills and what you'll be doing on the trip. Since we are both gonna be hunting, they let us have 2 sturdy calm horses that are used to being in the mountains. Just gonna walk over to the man that is gonna provide us with the horses.
Hiya, you two have booked a mountain trip. Enjoy the ride. Oh, the horses are over there.
The man greeted us and, well, clearly assumed that we were the ones who had booked the trip. So apparently I will be riding a horse named Achilles. He is a Breton who is a stallion and is around 10 years old. Having been out on a trail a lot in his time, he seems very sturdy and I feel like we are gonna get along just fine. And Mizuu will be riding the fox trotter named Cash. She is a very experienced and calm horse who is a mare and is 12 years old. Apparently she is kinda new at her place, but she has been out on rides before and she seemed to do really well. We will be starting our journey here from Emerald Ranch all the way over to this place here in the Strawberry region. It is said to be a lot of deer over here. There was a nice big open campsite that the community built for everyone to use. We actually were supposed to have a guide with us on this trip, but sadly they had fallen ill and could not be present. We decided to head out on our own since I kinda knew the area. Since I do live in Valentine, where I also have my horse Picasso. Sadly, he is not very used to the sounds of guns, so I'd rather keep him clear from it. We decided that I should get a feel for my horse first, since Achilles seemed a lot calmer than Cash. So we decided to walk around a little bit on the open meadows. It is a really early morning at the moment and honestly, I am not a morning person and I feel like I'm gonna fall asleep in the saddle. But hey, you gotta do what you gotta do. When I am riding around, I do feel like Achilles is actually really nice to ride. I get a good feeling about him. We did decide to run around 30 minutes to see how they are doing. Cash seemed to be a little on the edge, while Achilles, well, seemed calm enough to fall asleep himself as he was walking. We took a few steps in trot and walk around in different patterns to make sure they felt okay with us. Then it was time to start our wonderful journey to our first stop, Valentine. At least, we're gonna pass Valentine. How ironic it is to pass my own home. I could see the cute little emerald ranch fade into the distance. It should take us around 1 to 3 hours to get to the campsite. The plan is to be there for 2 or 3 days, one day to travel there, the second day for hunting, and the third one for traveling back home. So in total, we're gonna be there for 2 nights. It is currently Friday at 7:30 a.m. The sun is shining brightly so far. We are at least lucky with the weather. I have a feeling that's not gonna last long. The horses do seem to be enjoying themselves. After another 30 minutes, we're getting closer to Valentine. Well, I am living here, and all I can say about this place is mud. Mud everywhere. Don't trip. Everything actually worked fine until we reached this waterfall, edge, or river, I'm not quite sure. I don't know why Cash started to act up, and she seemed quite frightened. She reared and backed up, almost walking into Achilles. Me and Mizuu took turns to be in the front during this trip, and Achilles seemed quite calm, so after some time, I decided to go around them and just gently squeeze the sides on him to make him take a few steps into the water to make sure if it seemed fine to cross. He had no problems and he was completely fine walking over. Cash, seeing Achilles walking over, managed to follow in the end. Thankfully. I'm not gonna go much into details, but we were there for a long time. It had already become 9 in the morning, and the sun was casting its light upon us. According to the map, this is the area where the camp was, we just needed to find it. We could see some buildings in the distance and we figured that it was the place we needed to go. Deer were roaming the meadows, along with amazing wild horses. The atmosphere felt so calming and it was barely any sounds except from the horses' hoofs and the sound of the animals roaming in the distance. We got to the campsite and it was kinda empty there with no other people around at the time. We saw some sort of sign before we entered that said something like, "Welcome to Strawberry Open Camp. Here there is food and water for the horses, wood for the fireplace and tents, and a cabin house to use of need. If you use the stalls, make sure to clean up after yourself. Best regards, Strawberry Community." Though what we could see when we entered, I don't think people really cared about cleaning after themselves. We then decided to hitch the horses and put them in a small pen after taking care of them. Then it was time to get something to eat by the campfire and do some practice shots with our bow and arrow. Since we figured it was quite late, we thought we could use the time for something good. Now, we are using scoped guns as well, but I myself personally prefer the bow and arrow, if the distance is not too long. We then decided to have a look at the area since we had not been here before. Not even me, who lives here. Like I mentioned, keep good use of the time. We tried to find good spots that could be good to use tomorrow morning, but in the end, we just kind of went as we went. Finally, it was time to get some sleep after a long trip. The house that we slept in was pretty decent. First morning at camp. We had already finished our breakfast and had tacked up our horses. We found a decent good hunting spot in the end the day before and decided to head back over there and try to shoot some deer. We stood in position and it was currently 8 a.m. The calm breeze, the mountains in the distance. We did see some deer or mountain goats. I'm not quite sure, but all I know is we missed every single shot in the end. Mizuu and I just laughed it off in the end. It is our first hunting trip and we did not expect to get anything. I'm just glad we did not shoot a deer in the leg or something. When I took my license, I was taught to shoot only if I felt sure that it would be a one hit. In the end, we also missed so many shots that it started raining, and we had to interrupt the hunt. We go back to the camp and decide to eat some food that we had brought with us. The rain had stopped as soon as we had come back to camp, and we decided it was no point of going back out, so we just decided to stay put. We had hitched Achilles and Cash near us. While we were chatting, it started to come darker. We started to get tired and wanted to go inside and actually lay down in bed. As we were just about to fall asleep, we heard a howl in the distance. This is when I thought this trip would end in disaster. Cash got spooked and managed to get loose. Achilles acted up a bit, but he actually was quite calm for the situation. The sound of wolves faded luckily, but me and Mizuu panicked. Cash had run off to who knows where. We just hoped that she was nearby and wasn't injured. We thought that it was strange that Cash was so jumpy. Of course, there were wild wolves nearby, but she had been a little strange on the way here. After 1 hour, we managed to find her standing near the water in the open fields, pretty close to the camp, though she saw us and started to run away. In the end, I tried to herd her back to the ranch site. Lucky for us, she seemed to know where she belonged. Then we decided it was best to lead them inside of the barn and to make sure that she was not injured. Achilles had been a good boy. No, for sure, I might even consider buying him in the future if he ever would be for sale. After what had happened, we decided to go back to bed to make sure we were rested and ready for a ride home tomorrow. In the end, luckily, Cash wasn't injured and everything was fine. Last morning at the camp. Morning arrived and it was time to head back home to where it all began, Emerald Ranch. We had a quick breakfast and made sure the horses were taken care of with a long journey ahead of us. Here's a little montage of us riding home. The ride home was calmer and it was easy to cross the river this time. Well, it might have been because we decided to take Cash and Achilles downstream because it seemed a little more calmer down there. The ride home seemed to go faster than it did on the way here. Nature never stops to amaze me, and I could easily just sit and take pictures all day. We finally were back at Emerald Ranch and left the horses, and we told the man what had happened and how Cash had behaved. He just sort of brushed it off like it was nothing, but even if Cash had behaved the way she still had been a good horse.
You're back. I'm sure it all went fine, huh?
We then took the train to Valentine, and that is the end of our little hunting trip. In the end, not so much hunting, but it was a nice experience, though I'm happy that those wolves did not come any closer. That's gonna be it for this video. What do you guys think? If you liked this video, make sure to leave a comment and subscribe if you have not already. This video took so long to make, and writing the manuscript was quite interesting. Make sure to let me know if you want to see more videos like this, because I honestly really enjoy it. I can ride for hours in Red Dead just walking. It's so relaxing. Also, make sure to subscribe to my bestie, Mizuu, aka Mizuu Soup, if you have not already. She is a German YouTuber, but she has great content. And honestly, you don't even need to know the language to enjoy this kind of view. Thank you all so much for watching, and see you all next time. Bye bye, y'all.